God, it's the machines are starting to take over.
Google has taken over all of our smartphones, whether we like it or not. If you're using an Android, then your operating system is developed mostly by Google. Your apps are purchased through the Google Play Store. Your phone is sending data back to Google about which Wi-Fi networks are in your vicinity and which cell towers you're near. And sorry to break it to you, but even if you're using an iPhone, you likely still have Google's fingerprints all over your phone through the apps that you use. Google Maps can log everywhere you go and how long you stay there, even if you never open the app. Google records every search you perform and every YouTube video that you watch. There are likely apps on your phone that you didn't even realize were owned by Google companies. This installation at a privacy exhibit in San Francisco shows you all of the companies associated with Google. It's actually shocking how many of them there are. And a lot of these apps will collect your timestamped location data and send that, along with a bunch of other data, right on back to Google. So, how do you cleanse your phone of its Google demons?
Depart from the servant of God, demon!
I went to a de-Google your phone install party the other weekend, where we eliminated these data-collecting devils from our phones once and for all. All it took was two big steps, which I'll show you in this video. First, you need to install a new operating system on your phone that better protects your privacy and security. Stick with me, it's not as scary as it sounds. We're going to dive into the operating system Graphene, and I'll explain how it works and walk you through the install process. The second step to de-Googling, you need to stop using Google apps. Yes, I totally understand. These apps are ingrained in our daily lives. Deleting them will feel like cutting off a limb. But not only will deleting these Google apps make you feel empowered because you're reclaiming a huge amount of your data and privacy, but you won't even miss them. There are some really awesome alternatives to YouTube app, Chrome, Authenticator, Maps, and all the rest, and I'll show you where to find them. I'm also considering offering phones on my website with Graphene and all these core apps that I use pre-installed. So if this is something that you might be interested in, then let me know on my website so that I can gauge interest.
Shall we begin?
So what is Graphene? Well, broadly, it's an operating system for your phone. You've probably heard of Android and iOS, which are the two most popular operating systems for phones, but there are also operating systems out there based on Android, but with free and open source software. One of the most highly regarded of these is Graphene. What makes Graphene special is that it has a long list of enhancements to harden the security of your device, including app sandboxing, automatically purging logs after 10 days, not allowing persistent cookies other than logins, and a lot of other impressive and far more technical sounding stuff. It's so secure that Edward Snowden once said that if he were configuring a smartphone, he'd use GrapheneOS as the base operating system. Normally, you might expect these privacy alternatives to be a little clunky, a little less usable. But one thing I'll say right off the bat about Graphene is that it's actually surprisingly easy to use and feels just like using any Android phone. I've been really impressed with my experience and will dive further into my takeaways at the end of the video. Graphene is made specifically for Pixel phones. So if you already own a Pixel, then you can install it on this existing device. But keep in mind, the install process completely erases everything on your phone. So make sure that you back everything up, or you can do the install on a new phone like I did. Now for the actual install. To install Graphene, you can choose to use the command line, but following the instructions on the GrapheneOS website does require some extra coding knowledge not explicitly stated in the instructions. Or you can use the web installer.
We can do this the easy way or the hard way.
Let's do the easy way. First off, have a computer and a USB-C cord handy. Turn on your new Pixel and set it up as usual. We will be wiping the device in a moment, but first you want to make sure that it has the latest firmware updates installed. Head to Settings, System, Advanced, and System Update. Keep updating that until no more updates appear. It's also a good idea to make sure that your computer system and browser are both updated. First step of the install, you need to enable OEM unlock. OEM stands for Original Equipment Manufacturer, and enabling this allows you to unlock your device's bootloader. It all sounds very complicated, but basically, phone manufacturers put certain locks in place deliberately so that you can't mess with the operating system and break your phone. So, in order to delete that operating system and replace it with our own, we're going to enable some sneaky hidden developer tools on the phone.
I am very, very sneaky, sir.
Go to Settings, About Phone, and repeatedly press the Build Number menu entry until Developer Mode is enabled. Yes, it seems weird, but just press the Build Number over and over until you get a pop-up that says you're now a developer.
Sneaky little rabbits.
Next, go to Settings, System, Develop Options, and toggle on the Enable OEM Unlocking setting. You will need to be connected to the internet. Then, boot your phone into the bootloader interface. You'll connect the phone to the computer, turn the phone off, and then press the On button and Volume Down button simultaneously while the phone boots. You'll get this black screen, which is the bootloader interface. On your computer, head to the GrapheneOS.org's web install page. There's a button that says Unlock Bootloader. Click that and wait for the progress bar to finish and the words Finished Unlocking Bootloader to appear. This will wipe all data on the phone. Then you'll confirm the unlock on the device itself. Press the volume keys to toggle through options until you get the words Unlock Bootloader, and then press the power button to confirm. The next step is downloading the GrapheneOS factory images, which you can think of as a set of software packages or a file system that you download for quick and consistent installation of that software. To get these factory images, click Download Release and wait for the progress bar to complete. Next, you will be flashing the factory images, which basically means replacing the existing operating system with the new one. Click Flash Release. Avoid interacting with the device until the flashing script is finished and the device is back at the bootloader interface. This can take a while to get through all the different stages. Once it's all done, it's time to lock the bootloader. This means that you lock the Graphene operating system in to prevent any unauthorized changes. If that lock state ever changes to unlocked again, it wipes all the data on the phone. So this prevents anyone from installing a malicious operating system that might try to collect this data. Click Lock Bootloader. Then confirm the command on your device. Use the volume keys to select Lock Bootloader and then hit the power button to select. You've now successfully installed GrapheneOS and can restart your phone. Final step. Once your phone has restarted with Graphene, go to Settings, About Phone, press the Build Number until you're a developer again, and then go to Settings, System, Developer Options, and this time toggle off the OEM unlocking.
We don't need you.
And you're done. Now it's time to install some Google alternative apps. You can't use the Google Play Store because we don't want to use Google at all on this device. And you can't use the Apple App Store because that's only available for iPhones. So you're going to install an app called F-Droid directly from their website. It's another kind of app store, full of free and open source software that's built on F-Droid's servers. And all these apps are compatible with your new Graphene phone. Not all the apps you might want to use will be available on F-Droid. Some might only be available on Google Play. So there's a sneaky workaround. Through the F-Droid App Store, you'll download an app called Aurora. The Aurora Store is a privacy-respecting front end for everything on the Google Play Store. It downloads the APKs from Google Play for you. APK stands for Android Package Kit and is the file format used when installing Android applications if you want to install them from outside the Google Play Store. Aurora handles the install for you as well as updates, and it does this with either an anonymous account or your own Google account to access apps that you've paid for. The advantage is you don't need to have Google Play services, which is basically Google's rootkit spyware, installed on your device. The Play Store will refuse to work without Google Play services, but Aurora gets around this. The cool thing is that only Aurora's server's IP will be shown to Google, so Google won't know that it's you downloading the app. Now, this doesn't mean that you want to put just any app on your phone. Have a good look at the permissions the app is asking for before downloading anything. And if it asks for too many permissions, you might just want to stop using that app. F-Droid has a section under each app in their store called Things You Might Not Like that warns you about how the app might compromise your privacy. Here are apps that I would recommend you start with. From Aurora, I download the Signal app. Then from F-Droid, for a Google Maps alternative, Organic Maps and OSM and are good options. For browsers, DuckDuckGo is a great choice. DuckDuckGo is better known as a search engine, but they do have a browser available just for smartphone, and it's really great. Tor is another must-have browser for privacy. For media, I have the library app to watch all my favorite library channels, NewPipe, which allows me to watch YouTube videos, and AntennaPod for podcasts. Mulvad and ProtonVPN are both great VPN options. And OTP is a great alternative to Google Authenticator. And of course, any self-respecting privacy phone needs some crypto wallets. Unstoppable is a great multi-coin wallet that also supports shielded Zcash, but there are a bunch of others to choose from. Plus, there are a ton of apps for Graphene that are not just Google replacements, but awesome tools for increasing your privacy and security in general, like Pilfershush that jams your microphone, UntrackMe that removes tracking links from URLs, and Scrambled Exif that removes metadata from photos before you share them. I'll dive into all these awesome apps and more in a separate video. I'll also dive into Shelter, which is a way to create different user profiles on your Graphene phone so that, for example, none of your apps in your work profile have access to your contact lists in your personal profile. There are so many possibilities with Graphene, and I think you will have a lot of fun trying them out. Now, to finish up my personal phone setup, I add a privacy screen to my phone, which stops people nearby seeing what I'm doing on my phone. I add a physical microphone jammer, although be aware of the limitations of mic jammers. And I add a cover to the front camera. As I mentioned, I am thinking of offering on my website phones with my exact setup, all of the apps that I have installed, and including all of the little extra gadgets, as a pre-installed package. So if this is something that might interest you, then head on over to my website and let me know that you are interested. As impossible as it may seem at first glance, it is actually not that difficult to live a Google-free lifestyle, enjoying almost all the usual things you would do on your phone without compromising your privacy. My main takeaway from Graphene is that it's a lot smoother than I expected. Granted, it's not as polished as an Android or iPhone, but what it lacks, I really don't miss, because taking this huge step to reclaim my privacy feels so good. Yes, Google is everywhere in the digital world. Yes, tracking on the internet is pervasive. Yes, Skynet still might happen, but it doesn't have to include your data.